Mariusz Pudzianowski was known as the Dominator for good reason. The five-time winner of the World's Strongest Man literally dominated the strongman scene in the early to mid-noughties, and today still holds the record for the most World's Strongest Man title wins. Mariusz was also 7 times Poland's Strongest Man, a 6-time winner of the Europe Strongest Man title, and won a whole host of other international competitions. Today we're going to take a look back at the career of this strongman legend and some of what I consider to be his most impressive performances in the sport. Mariusz's father was an Olympic weightlifter, and Mariusz started hitting the weights himself when he was 13 years old. In 1999, when he was just 22 years old, Mariusz entered his first strongman competition, and just a year later, in the year 2000, he appeared at the World's Strongest Man, taking 4th place. We all know about Mariusz's success at the World's Strongest Man, but just as impressive to me was him winning 12 of the Strongman Super Series competitions. These were the equivalent to the Giants Live shows we have today, and served as a qualifier for the World's Strongest Man. So let's take a look at a few of my favourite Mariusz performances. Mariusz was probably best known for his ability to move with weight, whether that was the Conan Circle, the Husafell Stone, a loading race, yoke or farmer's walk, the man didn't have a weakness and was so often head and shoulders above the competition when it came to these type of events. Mariusz wasn't one to drop points when it came to the static events, and still placed highly on events such as the deadlift and log lift, particularly when it came to reps. The man was an absolute animal, and showed grit, determination, and a work ethic like no other. At the 2005 Sweden Super Series, the last event was a medley, which consisted of 120kg Atlas Stone, 150kg Farmer's Walk, and then loading 3 kegs while wading through a shallow swimming pool. It was the last event of a long competition, and while it wasn't the heaviest event, the fatigue was evident amongst the athletes, with some unable to finish, and the best finishing time being 51 seconds by Dave Osland. The conditions were very wet after heavy rainfall, but not enough to slow down Mariusz, who finished the event in 41 seconds, 10 seconds ahead of 2nd place. At the 2006 Grand Prix held in Poland, the first event was 150kg farmer's walk across a 60-meter course, with a turn that proved tricky for a few of the athletes. Mariusz blitzed it with a finishing time of 19.9 seconds, a great start to the competition that he ended up winning with a 15.5-point margin. At that same competition, the athletes faced a 365kg yoke on a 30-meter course. Mariusz finished in 8.96 seconds, nearly 4 seconds faster than 2nd place. His run was so quick, the most difficult part was the dismount at the end. The Conan Circle at the 2006 Mohegan Sun Grand Prix was a particularly difficult one, with a few of the athletes commenting about how imbalanced it was. After watching Hugo Girard suffer a nasty injury where his knee buckled under the weight of the Conans, Mariusz was up next, but undeterred, he took the Conans for a 120-foot walk, comfortably winning the event. At the 2005 Mohegan Sun, the athletes had to walk 30 meters with a 175kg farmer's walk without dropping it. Mariusz won the event and was one of just 2 athletes able to complete the course. It's a loss that the grip king Odd Haugen didn't take too well. At this Grand Prix held in Poland in 2005, the athletes had to flip a tire 8 times on a grass course. It was the 7th event of the day, but Mariusz looked as fresh as he did for the first event, taking an easy win with 8 flips in 25 seconds. Sticking with that same competition, the next event was an Atlas Stone Run, a 5-stone run weighing 120 to 180 kilos. Marius completed the run in 20 seconds, at a time when many strongmen weren't able to pick up and load 180 kilo stone. That same competition ended with the Power Stairs, one of Marius's favourite events. Here you can see a fairly normal looking performance from two world-class strongmen after a hard day of competition. Now let's cut to Marius, and you can truly appreciate how ridiculously quick he was at these type of events. Only one other athlete was able to complete all three implements in a time of 43 seconds, while Marius finished the run in 28 seconds. At his first World Strongest Man competition in 2000, Marius was placed in a group with Zdrunas Soviskas and Phil Pfister, two athletes who would eventually go on to become winners themselves. Marius won the group and placed fourth overall in the finals. Not bad at all for his first showing. Here he is taking the Africa Stone for a 110 meter walk, becoming the first man able to carry it more than 100 meters. The carry and drag from the World's Strongest Man 2002 heats is probably one of Marius's most impressive performances ever. 18 athletes completed the event across three groups, and only two were able to finish the course. Magnus Samuelsson in a time of 47 seconds, and Marius Pudzianowski in an incredible 27 seconds. Marius's performance at the 2003 World's Strongest Man final is one of the most dominant performances ever seen in strongman. Marius won four of the events, came second in two, and third in the final event, having already won the competition before the final event started. In the final standings, he'd won with a 20-point margin. Here he is winning the deadlift, proving that he was just as competitive in the power events. Marius's performance on the power stairs at the 2008 finals was ridiculous. He didn't get off to a perfect start. These stairs were much, much bigger than we were used to seeing in strongman competition. But halfway up the course, he changed his technique and just went jet propelled, ending up winning by a full 14 seconds. But like I said at the beginning of this video, Marius was nicknamed the Dominator for good reason. He's still the only athlete to win the World's Strongest Man five times, and is one of the most highly decorated strongmen of all time. While you're here, guys, subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my awesome strength content.